So one thing you have to be able to do under exam conditions is take an algorithm that's already been presented to you and then be able to refine it or improve it in order to make it more robust and more resilient using various techniques we've covered in previous videos. So we're going to use the same program that we've been using throughout these videos as an example. So here's the code as it stands at the moment. Now with this program, we know we'd like the user to enter either 1, 2 or 3. And as we can see from the output window, if they do, the program works and behaves as expected. However, there is nothing that prevents the user from typing in unexpected or invalid inputs, even if you don't want them to. And a robust program should handle this. For example, here they've typed in 2.5. We'd like it to reject that because there is no menu option 2.5. The decimal numbers between 1 and 3 are being accepted, although they're not valid menu choices. So one option to make the program more robust, and I'm not saying this is the best option, but one could be to force the input from the user into an integer data type. So you can see that down the bottom, choice equals int input. So whatever the user types in, we force into an integer. And then we check if the choice is between the integers 1 and 3 instead of between the characters 1 and 3. Well, this has fixed the problem, sort of. So now nothing other than whole numbers, integers, can be accepted. So 2.5 originally was being accepted. Well, now it's being rejected, you can see at the top. However, it's introduced another problem. The program now crashes if anything other than an integer is entered. So this program is far from robust yet. The program also doesn't provide very useful feedback for the user if they enter integers which are outside of the accepted range. So all of these entries below are considered invalid data. So that's data of the correct data type, they're integers, but they're outside the range 1, 2 and 3. And you can see it just keeps saying enter choice, enter choice, enter choice. It's not providing some very useful feedback to the user. This second problem is easy to fix by simply making the prompt to the user slightly more descriptive. So now it says enter a choice 1, 2 or 3. And this is an easy example of making a program more robust, providing additional useful information to the user. Ideally though, we don't want the program to crash when an invalid data type is entered. For this, we can make use of simple error catching code. This asks you to try this line of code, and if that line of code generates an error, then instead of crashing the program, catch the error and instead run the code after the accept line. And this is known as exception handling. Now this is a little beyond the scope for the exam, but it's really, really useful to know and very simple to execute. So now you can see if I type in the letter J, that previously would have caused my program to throw an error and crash. But instead my line choice equals int input is being executed after the try. So it tries that line, and when an error is generated, it catches the error, stopping your program from crashing, and then it jumps to the accept line and provides me with some useful input. Invalid input, you must enter 1, 2 or 3. So let's just recap what we've gone through. Refining algorithms to make them more robust is about writing code which anticipates a range of possible inputs. Those inputs could be invalid data or erroneous data. Make sure bad data doesn't crash the program. Making sure prompts to the user are descriptive and helpful. Making sure only data of the correct data type is entered. And checking and handling missing or blank data. One common option is to use simple exception handling commands like the ones we've shown you, which are available in most programming languages.